At first glance, it looked like just another ordinary day at the dam. The sun was shining, the water seemed calm, and the towering gates stood firm as guardians of the reservoir. To the untrained eye, nothing appeared out of place, but deep below the surface, hidden from view, a silent battle was waiting to unfold, one that would test the limits of men, machines, and the very balance of nature itself. It all began at gate number 3. The team had a simple task: remove the stop logs. But the stop logs refused to move. They were jammed deep in the riverbed, locked in a cement-like grip of mud and silt that had built up over time. The powerful lifting beam groaned and strained, metal against metal, trying again and again to tear them free. But nature held its ground. The logs did not budge. There was only one option left: send divers down into the murky depths. Men willing to disappear into cold, dark waters, feeling their way blindly through mud and debris, digging with their bare hands to free the logs. But as soon as the plan was set, a deadly complication surfaced. Right next to gate 3, gate number 2 was wide open, thundering with the force of thousands of tons of water rushing through. That flow created a suction so powerful it could pull in anything nearby: debris, machines, even men. For divers, entering that current would be like swimming into the jaws of death. The risk was unthinkable. The divers made their stance clear: shut gate 2, or we don't go down. But shutting down gate 2 meant stopping water flow, something that wasn't an option. The engineers had to improvise, and fast. There was only one alternative: fire up radial gate 1. Yet this option carried its own dangers. Gate 1 hadn't been touched in over a year. No one knew what lay behind it. Months of silt, tangled logs, and unseen blockages could all be waiting, ready to unleash chaos. Still, it was the only chance. The order was given. Slowly, the massive steel gate began to lift. At first, nothing. Then, with a deep, thunderous roar, nature struck back. A violent surge of water burst through, dragging with it months of trapped silt and debris. The crystal-clear reservoir turned in an instant into a raging, mud-filled torrent, a chocolate river raging through the dam. The gamble had paid off. With gate 1 open and gate 2 finally closed, the deadly suction vanished. For the first time, it was safe for the divers to descend. Down they went, disappearing into the swirling brown waters. Visibility was near zero. They worked by feel, clawing through the thick mud, scraping around the logs inch by inch. Hours passed, the cold pressed in, the current tugged at their bodies, but slowly, surely, progress was made. Until finally, with one last push, the stop logs came free. Gate 3 was released from its muddy prison. What looked like a simple mechanical failure was in truth a battle of patience, courage, and engineering brilliance. A story of men who risked their lives beneath the waterline, of machines pushed to their limits, and of quick decisions that kept danger at bay. This was more than a stuck gate. It was proof of the razor-thin line between control and chaos when working with the raw power of water. And this is just one story. Behind every gate, every turbine, and every reservoir, there are untold battles like this, battles that define Pakistan's hydropower world. Stay tuned, because the dam always has another story to tell.
Yeah, कल एक फंस गया यहाँ पे आ गया ना, ये रोप से उठाया था ना, तो ये साइड थोड़ी लंबी थी, यहाँ पे आगे अड़ गया, वो बड़ी मुश्किल से उधर उसको पास करवाया।
इसके बाद तो